What's good, YouTube? This your boy Chi World back at y'all again with another art tutorial. If you're new to the channel, go ahead and hit that like button, comment, subscribe. Make sure you hit post notifications so you will be notified every time your boy drops some heat. In today's video, I will be joining a very successful YouTuber. His name is Jake Paul. And I will be turning him into a cartoon, showing you guys how to do it step by step. And another thing I want to tell you guys, I will be having a giveaway as soon as your boy hit 100K subs. And I will be choosing 5 winners for the giveaway. And all you have to do for a chance to win is make sure you subscribe to the channel and hit post notification, and you will have a chance to be one of the winners. And let's jump right into this video. First thing you want to do, if you're using a digital tablet, you want to come up here and set the pressure on your pen to get that brush you always see me using. Just come right here, click pressure, click 3, put 3 right here and click OK. And now you should have that brush you be seeing me use. Let's jump right into it, man. We're gonna drop the opacity down on this picture. And we're gonna start out by doing the line work. And the color, I'm gonna start with, for the line work, it's a dark brown. So let's jump right into this thing. Make sure you're doing some nice clean lines. I Okay, now that we finish with the line work, what you want to do is you want to select everything, go to object, expand appearance, then you want to go to window, get out your pathfinder and click merge. After you do that, you want to drag the line work to this blank sheet of paper, make a copy, lock the top copy, come to your second one, find a nice skin tone to start with. Let's see what we want. That'll be pretty good to start with. Go to your rectangle tool and drag the color over the artwork. Then you want to right click the color, go to arrange, send to back. After you do that, you want to highlight everything, go to your pathfinder and click merge. And then what you want to do, you want to right click onto it, isolate select group, and now you can delete and switch colors around. So we're going to change the eye color, hold shift, another thing we're gonna do too, we're gonna click this drop down menu and we're gonna scroll down and we're gonna lock all of the line work layers, just the line work layers, and leave these unto these the two up top, we're gonna leave them unlocked. Then you're gonna close it, and now we're gonna get it out our white selection tool. Then we're gonna delete the unwanted colors. Little shadow. We're gonna start doing our shading. So you want to add a new layer in between the line work and the color layer we made. So we're gonna find, get our dropper tool out, sample the skin tone color, come to it, and we're gonna find a good little mix. don't like it, we can always switch it up at the end. So I'm gonna click OK. Now it's time to do our shadows. And I like to start from dark, from the dark shadows, and work my way to the lighter. Quicker way to fill in is to come right here, select your pencil tool, and move the color to the back. And now we can just trace the lines we made. Same process. I think I want to make that shadow a little darker, so what we're going to do, we're going to highlight it, and we're going to go to Object, Edit Color, we're going to come right here, Color Harmony, and we're going to tweak it a little bit. Okay, I'm finna add some shades, some shadows inside the eyes. Back to our pencil tool. same thing. A nice little shadow. Do we gonna add one more layer for the shadows before we go to the hair, and we're gonna add it under that shadow layer. We're gonna do it like a brighter shadow now. So we went from dark, now we can go to light. So let's find a nice in between color. Stop it right here. See how it looks looking. So we're gonna switch the color up to one once we finish, so it'll blend with everything a little better. Let's go ahead and finish this. Now that we made a good shadow for the brighter color, what we're gonna do, we're gonna unlock the darker shadow and we're gonna unlock the brighter shadow, and we're gonna highlight them both. After you do that, you wanna come up here to edit color, come right here, go to color harmony, and now we're gonna tweak them so we can make them blend better with each other. We're gonna bring this one down some. Now that we did that, we're gonna add a layer above everything. And what we're gonna do first, we're gonna add detail to these eyes. So what you wanna do, you want to lock this layer. Make sure this one is on the top. Then you wanna get out your pencil tool. White, lock this bottom layer. Gonna do the little highlights in the eyes. Okay, that's looking nice. Lock that layer, add another one. And now we finna move on to the hair. Now, the reason I made the hair this color, so it'll blend good once we start adding our lines and give it a nice little fix. So what we're gonna do, you got like gold hair, so let's find like a goldish blonde. So all we gotta do, come right here to our brush. Time you spend on it, like the dope, the more better the effect will come out. So now what we're gonna do, we're gonna go a little darker. last thing we're gonna do is add some highlights on the face. So I'm gonna drag it right here, a little layer. Sample the skin tone. Got a pencil tool.